Good evening. Ides and Duckwall Recital Hall and the Butler Arts and Events Center thank you for tuning into tonight's event. Recordings of this evening's concert, as well as other archival recordings, may be accessed on butlerartscenter.org. Now please relax and enjoy the show.
Thank you so much for tuning into my live stream this evening. I hope you're all wide awake after that first piece, because that was Wake Up by Tillman Dinehard, and it was actually a duet on the flute, on the piccolo and the alarm clock. So in order to play this piece, I actually had to send an email to the composer, and I forwarded him some money, and he sent me the alarm clock in the mail. And Karen, Becky, and I just had so much fun putting it together because, of course, it's kind of a unique piece. Next up, we have the Pied Piper, which is, if you're not familiar with the story of the Pied Piper, I'm gonna tell it to you because this piece does musically tell that story to you. It's a little bit dark, so fair warning. But the Pied Piper is this story about a town that's infested with rodents. And so they call up this magical flute man that can hypnotize animals and is like, can you get rid of these rats for us? And he does his flute thing and hypnotizes all of the rats, and they all go and drown themselves in the river. But these townspeople were extremely greedy, and then they refused to pay the Pied Piper. And so in retaliation, the Pied Piper was so upset, he actually hypnotized the townspeople's children and hypnotize them to march to their deaths into the river. So this next piece tells that story. The first movement is called The Spell. So it's the Pied Piper casting the spell on the children. It's very magical, it's whimsical. And then the second piece is a lot more angry and aggressive, and it's called The March to the River Weiser. And this is where the children ultimately meet their doom. So I hope you enjoy this next piece. accompanying me on the piano. That piece was one of Mozart's many sonatas that he wrote. And the reason why Karen and I decided to learn this piece over the past couple years was because last year I actually decided to study abroad in Vienna, Austria, and if I was going to live in Austria, I just had to learn a piece by Mozart, right? So while I was in Austria, I actually really got to know Mozart on like a different kind of level. I was able to go and visit his house and learn all about his childhood, which actually brings up a really interesting point about this piece. Mozart was 8 years old when he wrote it. So there's a lot of kind of childish, like youthful themes in it, and that's entirely why. So for my last piece, I am playing something very different than Mozart. And it's called Danse de la Chèvre, and it's by Arthur Honegger. It's a French piece, and Danse de la Chèvre actually translates to the Dance of the Goats. So this piece is about a little goat waking up one morning to find that the snow has all of a sudden disappeared, and it's now there's bright green grass everywhere. It's suddenly spring. And this piece is very much like following the story of this goat and what he does on his first day of spring. So when Karen and I were learning this piece, we played around with a lot of different ideas of what this goat was doing, including like chasing its tail or playing with some friends or maybe wandering up a little too high in the mountains. So when you listen to this last piece, I encourage you to think about what that goat is doing while I'm playing. Thank you all so much for popping on the live stream tonight and supporting me. It really means a lot, and I hope you enjoy Danse de la Chèvre.
Thank you for attending tonight's performance. Be sure to visit butlerartscenter.org for more information on our upcoming events. Thank you.